Very nice. Everybody have drawn very nicely. Okay, thank you so much. And let us start today's session. It's almost 5 now. Hope you all have learned that sloka. Harer nama, harer nama, harer namaiva kevalam. Kalo nasteva, nasteva, nasteva gadir anyada. In this age of Kali Yuga, okay, there is no other way, no other way, no other way except the chanting of the holy name of the Lord, which is Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Okay, so the chanting of the holy name is the prescribed method in the age of Kali Yuga, which you are all doing, okay? So that's the only way to get out of this problem of birth and death. Okay. Yes, so it's 5 o'clock. Let us start. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurmidam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Nama Shri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupakata Mahyam Tadanti Swapadantikam Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swamina Namine Namaste Sarasvadeve Gauravani Prajalini Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschati Deshadarni Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasati Kaur Bhaktavrinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Gaura Chandraya Radhikaya Tatale Krishna, Hare Krishna, Bhaktaya Tatpaktaya Namo Nama. Okay, so ISKCON Mangalore Children's Program welcomes you to the 7th day session. So chapter 7 is Jnana Vijnana Yoga. Okay, so what is yoga? Yoga means what? Whoever knows the answer, please raise your hand. Vaishnavi, what is yoga? You know?
Yes.
Yoga means?
Yoga means connecting to God.
Yes. So connecting to God. What are the types of yoga you know, Vaishnavi?
Karma yoga.
Yes, karma yoga.
Karma yoga, jnana yoga.
Jnana yoga. Then? Yesterday we learned something, no?
Ashtanga yoga, yoga,
Bhakti yoga.
Bhakti yoga.
And which is the highest? Highest
Bhakti
is?
Yoga.
Very
Bhakti
good,
yoga.
Yes. Very good. Okay. So, Jnana Vijnana yoga means, this is also connecting to God. How? Jnana and Vijnana. That means knowledge. Okay, knowledge of the absolute. Now, we'll see how the knowledge of absolute helps us. Knowledge of the absolute. Who is absolute? The Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna. Okay, so let us learn more about Krishna and his the powers of Krishna. Okay. So, where did that go? Okay. So yoga means connecting to God, and through jnana and vijnana, that means jnana and vijnana is nothing but the knowledge of absolute. Now you are all studying Bhagavad Gita, right? So studying Bhagavad Gita is also to know Krishna. Okay. So we are trying to know Krishna. Okay, there is some problem with my computer, so let me fix it. So, this is Jnana Vijnana Yoga, that is knowing of Krishna. So, who is God? Who is God? What is his name? Shravya Mataji, please, Reena Mataji, please unmute somebody. Who is God and what is his name?
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Hare Krishna. Yes.
I am Parvi Mataji. Mataji, God is a person and his name is Krishna. And he meditated on his Shyam Sundar form, the yellow garment, Neela Mega Shama, and need to make a shama color and the peacock feather color. Peacock
very
feather.
Good. The peacock feather. Yes. So that is Krishna, right? Okay. So God is Krishna and he is a person, right?
Yes, Mataji.
Yeah, many people in the quiz, they have written like some energy or something. So I'll show you. I got all the quiz and I'm correcting it. And most of them have written it as energy. But that's not the thing, okay? Krishna is not energy. He is a person. Co-host, can you see my screen?
Yes, Mataji. Yes, we can, Mataji.
Yeah, it's just loading.
Yes, Mataji.
Okay, so we will see what in the seventh chapter Krishna is speaking about. Shri Bhagavan Vaja. Bhagavan means what? Krishna. Anjali, can you read?
Mataji.
Read, read.
Shri Bhagavan Vaja. Mayashtaka manaparta yogam yujana machaya. Asamya seya samgrama mam yata janya janyasa.
Translation?
Now here, O son of
Krita,
Arjun, how by practicing yoga is full consciousness of me with mind attached to me, you can know me in full.
Yes. So Bhagavan Vaja. Bhagavan is who? Krishna. They could have given as Shri Krishna Vaja, but they are giving as Bhagavan Vaja. Bhagavan means the supreme personality of Godhead, Krishna. Okay. He has six opulences. Mai asakta manapata yogam yunjam madashraya asamshayam samagramam yatatjnanasya chatat shrunu. Okay, so what does it mean? Pritha. Pritha is Kunti Devi. Okay, that is Arjuna's mother. So, son of Pritha means Partha is Arjuna. Okay, Partha is Arjuna. And Krishna is Partha Sarathi because he became the driver or charioteer. Pritha is Kunti Devi. And son of Pritha is Arjuna. So, Krishna is saying, oh Arjuna, you practice yoga in full consciousness of me. But the mind should be attached to Krishna. How is our mind like? Tanishri, how is the mind? It's like an animal. Which animal? Our mind is like something, no? Yesterday I told you. Chanchalam hi mana Krishna. Mind yes. Is like a?
Yes, Mataji.
Yeah, mind is like a which animal? It jumps from one tree to another tree.
Monkey.
Yeah. Mind is like a monkey because monkeys are very restless. They can't sit in a place. They're always active. Our mind is also like that. It keeps thinking something or the other. Okay. So that mind we should attach to Krishna. Krishna is saying we should attach our mind to Krishna. Okay. Then what will happen? We can be freed from all doubts. We won't have any doubts and we can go back to Krishna. Okay. So yes, so and also Krishna also say what happens when some people try to come to Krishna. Yes, Kushi, can you read? If you can read the sloka, you can read or you can read the translation, whatever you like.
Manushyanam sahas.
Ma'am,
I'll read the translation.
Yes.
Out of many thousands among men, one may envy dear for perfection, and of those who have achieved perfection, hardly one knows me in truth.
Yes, so Krishna says, Manushyanam sahasreshu kaschit yadati siddhaye yatatam api siddhana kaschit mam vedi tatvataha. Out of many thousands among men, one may endeavor for perfection. And of those who have achieved perfection, hardly one knows Krishna in truth. Remember, Charvi, we had this in Bhakti Vriksha today. So after you finish your 18 days course, okay, you all, you can join Bhakti Vriksha, which is the second level of learning. Okay, there we will make you learn the slokas, recite slokas. We'll show you some cartoons regarding Krishna, some stories of Krishna. Okay, and it will be fun. It is on every Sundays at 10:30 a.m. Just on Sundays, nothing else. It's not there any other day. And you can join after this 18-day session. Okay, I will send you the link, WhatsApp group, and you can join. So in that, we learned this sloka. This is an important sloka. But for you, today, this is not the homework. I will tell you another important sloka in this chapter where you should learn. But in this, Krishna says, see, you can see here now, so many people are here, right? So many. They're going for a marathon. Marathon means what? Running race, right? So when you go, would everyone will be able to complete the race? Mithilesh, will everyone will be completing the race?
No, Mataji. Only
few, some, right?
Yes.
And among that, who will win? Only one person can become the first place, right?
Yes, Mataji.
Yes. So similarly, whoever wants to know about Krishna, 1,000 people will want to know about Krishna. Okay, many people registered. You know, 2,000 children registered for the program. And just few of them came. And in that, only some will stay till 18 days. Okay, I will see who all are going to stay at the end of 18 days. Okay, so some people only will stay for 18 days. After that, only some will go for Bhakti Vriksha and try to know more about Krishna. And so Krishna says, hardly one knows me in truth. Okay, so everyone will try to understand Krishna, but not everyone are able to understand. Likewise, many will go for a marathon race. Marathon means what? Kilometers and kilometers you have to run. Okay, so many of you can see here, na? Many of them are tired after running. They can't run. They stop or they leave it. Okay, like that, people can't understand Krishna, so they leave everything and go. Some people can't understand Krishna. Why? Why? Because I'll tell you why. So you can see here, the next slide shows that not everyone are able to understand Krishna. Okay, so not everyone are able to understand Krishna. Why is it so? Because some people are they want to know about Krishna. They are very inquisitive, okay, to know about Krishna. But then they won't get a right guru. Some people will get a fake guru. So you've seen some fake gurus coming. They'll tell, give us money. We will do that. We will do this. Did you see, Niranjan? Some fake gurus will come now with so much beard and everything. And they'll tell, I am God. So how can you prove they are not God, Niranjan?
We'll ask them to show the form of Krishna, Mataji.
Which form?
Universe form.
Yes, very good. Universal form. You should ask if anyone come to you. Okay, many people are sitting here. If anybody comes and tell you, I am God, main Ishwar ho, then you should tell, okay, I will believe that you are God, but you show your universal form. Only Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, can show the universal form. That's why even Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who's Krishna himself, who came in Kali Yuga, he also showed the universal form to Advaita Acharya. Okay, so some people, they want to know about Krishna, but they won't get a right guru. Some fake gurus are there who will, just for money, they come and ask you. But some people, if you're fortunate, okay, some people, they will get the right guru, okay? Yes, so Srila Prabhupada is one of them. He's a very right guru because he comes in the Sampradaya, the Brahma Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya. He's the 32nd Acharya and he follows the right disciplic succession and he gave this Bhagavad Gita as it is to us. And Srila Prabhupada never said he is God. When he went to America, he made so many temples. He was so rich, but still he always tells, I am the servant of God. I am not God. He never tells he is God. Okay, so and then if you get the right guru also, only some people will follow the regulative principles. We have 4 principles, okay, like no meat eating, no gambling, no intoxication, no illicit sex. But this I will tell you later. But just think that there are just understand there are four principles to follow. Any spiritual life, you should follow the four principles. Okay. Now, Krishna is explaining what Krishna is in this verse. Sai Ganesh, can you read?
Yes, Mataji.
Yeah.
Bhumir apo nalo vayuhu khammano buddhir eva cha ahankara ityam me bhinna prakrit bhinna prakritir astada.
Translation?
Earth, water, fire, air, ether, mind, intelligence and false ego. Altogether, these right comprise my separated material energies.
Yes. So, Krishna is saying earth, water, fire, air, ether. These are the five things which our body is made up of. See, you can see here, imagine if this is us. Our body is mainly made up of earth, water, fire, air and ether. Okay, this material body. But inside we have our soul. And you can see here, this white spot is the soul. And we have Paramatma also in our heart. Okay, so Paramatma is in which form? What is the form of Paramatma and in our heart? Nimra? Geeta Machaji, is that you, Geeta?
Yes, Mataji. Geeta Machaji.
Yes, Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thank you.
Yes, Mataji.
Yes. So, in what form is Paramatma in our heart situated, Nimra? Like, what is the form?
Universal form.
No, no. Universal form is the form which Krishna will show. But Krishna is actually the two-handed form, right? With the flute. But Krishna is in our heart as four-handed Paramatma. Okay? The four-handed form. Four-handed form. Shangha Chakra Gada Padma. He's holding. So that is the form of Paramatma. Okay? In our heart. So you can see Paramatma is in our heart. That is the super soul. And we are soul. So our body is made up of earth, water, fire, air, ether. Bhumi apo nalo vayu. Bhumi apo nalo vayu. Kammano buddhire vacha. Ahankara iti amme. Binna pragrirashtada. And then earth, water, fire, air, ether. So this is the material body made up of. And mind, intelligence and false ego. That is our subtle body. All these things are Krishna's energy. Okay. So it's not our energy. It is Krishna's energy. That's why this body is also Krishna's. Krishna gave this body to us. Okay. We have gone through so many life, right? How many life we've gone through? Manish, you know, how many life we have gone and then finally we got human life, no?
Hare Krishna, Mataji, we have gone through like millions of lives.
How much? That's... Bhagavad Gita says something, some number. Some lakhs. 84 lakh species of life. 84 lakhs, okay? That's the minimum. We can't take more. But at least once all have gone through this 84 lakh species of life. Then we got this human form of life. And these are all Krishna's energy. Okay. This is all Krishna's separate energy. Okay. So Krishna, he creates all the universes around him. I'll tell you how that is created. Okay. Yes, Manish, can you read?
Yes. Yes, ma'am. Of all that is material and all that is spiritual in this world, now for certain that I am both its origin and dissolution.
So Krishna is saying all that is in material and spiritual. Okay, any material world is this, spiritual is above us, like Golok, Vrindavan, Vaikuntha. Whatever is there, Krishna is the origin. Somebody asked me, no? Who created Krishna? Nobody created Krishna. He is Govindam Adipurusham Tamaham Bhajami. He is the first person who created this universe. You remember there was some theory. I don't know, many of them would have not heard. It's something called Big Bang Theory. That the universe came from a chunk. Okay, something was there and it burst out. And then the universes are formed. This is what the scientists think. That nobody created this universe. This universe, just like that, it came. It's called Big Bang Theory. But Shastras tell that this is not the theory. See, even for that that thing to get into pieces, there should be somebody who's operating on that. And the universes are not formed just like that. There is a supreme power behind that. That is God. Okay. So Krishna says he is the origin of everything and dissolution also. He only destroys. See, when Krishna in the Vishnu form, his expansion is Vishnu, right? So when he is lying down, he can breathe, inhale and exhale. So when he exhales, all the universes are formed. When he inhales, everything is destroyed. Okay, this is what happens. And somebody asked me, there are some nine planet system, how many are there? That's all the scientists have discovered. But actually, millions of universes are there. Shastra says, see, Jagadanda Kodi. Yesya Prabhavo Prabhavido Jagadanda Kodi. Brahma Samhita says, Jagadanda Kodi. There are millions of universes formed. And this is one of the universe which we are living. There are millions of universes. And there is life in all the universe. Some scientists, they could not find out life on moon. And they say there is no life on moon. But yes, Shastra says there is life on moon. There is life on sun. But such people are living. We can't live there. Okay. In order to live in the sun planet, we should have a body of fire. But we are living in earth, and this earth, in earth, our body is made up of five elements. What are they? Earth, water, fire, air, ether. Okay, these are the five elements which our body is made up of. Okay, so our body is made up of these five elements. And okay, so these five elements our body is made up of. And then that's why at the time of death, the body is destroyed, right? But the soul does not destroy. What will happen to the soul? It will go to another body, right? So what does Krishna says after that? Suhas, can you read? Yes, Suhas?
Yes, Mataji.
Read.
O conqueror of wealth, Arjuna. There is no truth superior to me. Everything rests upon me as pearls are strung on a thread.
Yes, Suhas, you can see here, no? A pearl necklace. You can see a mala here.
Yes, Mataji.
Can you see the thread inside?
No, Mataji.
You can't see. Even I can't see the thread.
I can see the shadow.
Shadow. But you can't see the thread as such, right?
No, Mataji.
So is there thread inside?
Yes, Mataji.
If there is no thread, then what will happen to these beads?
Everything will be loose and everything will fall apart.
Similarly, we all are resting on Krishna. Krishna, okay? Well, Krishna is holding all of us, all this universe in place. It's not like it's standing. Sun is standing there. Moon is standing there. Okay, it is there. All the energies are acting. Bhumi also gravitational force is acting. But Newton discovered the gravitational force. And before that, Newton was born also. Gravity was here, right? So who actually created it? Krishna, God created it like that. But we can't see God. That doesn't mean God doesn't exist. Similarly, when there is a thread and the beads are on the thread, then it becomes a nice necklace. But if the thread is broken, nothing is there. But we can't see the thread. Similarly, Krishna is holding everything. But we can't see Krishna because we don't have the eyes to see Krishna. I told you that ointment of love we should have. Premanjana Chudita Bhakti Vilochanena. Then we can see Krishna. Krishna is saying, there is no truth superior to me. Matta Paradaram Naniyat. There is no truth superior to me. This is why we say Krishna is supreme. Because Krishna himself says in Bhagavad Gita. And Prabhupada says, Krishna is God. So whom should we believe? Krishna himself is saying in Bhagavad Gita, that nobody is superior to me. Then whom else we should believe? So Krishna is saying he is superior to me. Nobody is superior to him. And everything rests upon him. How? Like a pearl is strung. Okay. So everything rests upon Krishna. Okay. So Krishna is God. This is the lesson you should learn. Krishna is God and Krishna is God and he is a person. Please don't write his energy. Okay. In that quiz, many have wrote Krishna is energy. Krishna has energies like material energy, internal energy, external energy. That is different. That is Krishna's energy. But Krishna is a person, supreme person. Okay. Like this two-handed form. And there is nobody superior to Krishna. What is the reference? In Srimad Bhagavatam, it says, Krishna's to Bhagavan Swayam. Krishna is Swayam Bhagavan. In Bhagavad Gita also, Krishna says now, no, Matta Paradaram Naniyat. And there is nobody superior to me. In 10th chapter, he says, Aham Sarvasya Prabhuvo Matta Sarvam Pravartade. Everything comes from me. So that means Krishna is superior. And in Brahma Samhita also, it says, Ishvara Parama Krishna Sachit Ananda Vigraha Anadir Adir Govinda Sarva Karana Karanam. Krishna is the cause of all cause. So what proof else we need? All the big scriptures and shastras say that Krishna is superior. He is a person. Krishna is God and he is a person. And there is nobody superior to Krishna. Now Arjuna is understanding all this fact. Okay. Now Krishna is teaching Arjuna. Okay, Krishna is also saying, see, we are not able to see Krishna, right? But we see water every day, right? Every day we drink water. Almost all of everyone of you here drinks water, right? Vedant, so can you read this? I'll tell you how Krishna is explaining. Yes, Vedant.
I'm sorry, read the translation.
Yes. What are you like?
I am the taste of water, the light of the sun and the moon. The syllable om in the Ved mantras. I am the sound in ether and ability in man.
Yes. So it said, Rasoham apsu kaunteya prabhasmi shashi suryayo pranava sarva vedeshu shabdake paurusham rishu. So, O son of Kunti, that means Arjuna, Krishna is saying, I am the taste of water. Now, in science, in biology, in science, what did you learn? What is the taste? Parthiv, did you learn that water is tasteless, colorless, odorless?
Yes. No
matter. So actually, it is said that water is tasteless, colorless, odorless. Yes. But then, if somebody is fasting for so many days and you give water to them, still there is some taste of water, no? Some kind of taste. We can't say it is sweet or sour or anything, but some mixture of taste. And that taste is who? Who's the taste of water, Parthiv?
Krishna.
Yes. So Krishna says that I am the taste of water. Rasoham apsu kaundeya. How many times we drink water in a day, right? Every day we drink lots of water. Did you ever realize that the taste of water is Krishna? Okay, who provided this water to us? Krishna. And you've seen sun and moon every day. The light of the sun and the moon, both are Krishna. See, it's like Krishna's eyes. Sun is Krishna's one eye and moon is Krishna's another eye. So when the sun rises, Krishna will open one eye. And the moon rises, Krishna will open the other eye. Okay, sometimes both, you can see the sun and the moon, sometimes on full moon day or something. And then it's like that. So Krishna's, the light that's coming from the sun and the moon is Krishna. The syllable Om. You've heard so many mantras starting with Om, right? Satvik, tell me one mantra which starts with Om. You know? Om. Any mantra that starts with Om. Yes, Kriti. There are so many mantras.
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Yeah, what is a mantra that starts with Om? You know? Any mantra? There's so many mantras. Shiva Priyan. Yes, Pratid.
Ma'am, Vishnu Sahasranam.
Yeah. How does it start?
Om Shuklambarakram Vishnu Sahasranam.
Yes.
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Yes. Any mantra?
Even the Gayatri mantras also start with
yes. Om. Gayatri mantra. Om Bhurbhuvah Svah. Good. Yes. So, who's Om in all these mantras? Who's Om?
Krishna.
Yes, Krishna says, I am the syllable Om in the Vedic mantras. So, he is Om. If somebody is chanting Om and then any mantras, that is Krishna. But the Hare Krishna mantra is the Maha mantra. So, there is no Om in that because Hare Krishna mantra is Krishna himself. So, there is no need of adding Om to that. Okay. So, Krishna says, he is the taste of water, he is the light of sun and the moon, he is the syllable Om, the Vedic mantras, and he is the sound in ether and the ability in man. See, some people, they do something, they win some race, they get so much money, something, and they'll tell, yes, I did that. It's my power, my ability. If somebody dance well, sings well, they think that's their ability. Yes, it is their ability, but that ability is also Krishna. So Krishna is providing us all this strength. So if a person does not believe in God, okay, but if you show them the sun and the moon, who's making it rise, who's giving that that sunlight, the light energy of that sun, who's doing all this? That is Krishna God. Okay, there is a supreme power behind that, which is God. This is Krishna consciousness. You are able to see Krishna all the time. When you drink water, you can just remember Krishna. How? Oh, the taste of water is Krishna. Morning, when you see the sun, you can just think, oh, that is Krishna. So this is how you start appreciating everything around you as Krishna's energy and as Krishna's gift. Okay, so you can see some people, they drink water and they relish it. They enjoy drinking water. I like drinking water. If you give some juice and all, I can't drink more glass, but water I'll keep on drinking because that gives so much pleasance in us, right? If you want to keep your body hydrated, you should always drink water. Okay, as children, you should keep drinking water. You should not be thirsty and all. You should always keep your body hydrated. And Krishna says, O son of Kunti, I am the taste of water, the light of sun and the moon. The syllable Om in the Vedic mantras, I am the sound in ether and ability in man. So whenever you drink water, just try to think of Krishna. That is how you can always think of Krishna. And Krishna also says something else. Yes, Prateet, can you read? What does Krishna say?
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
I am the original fragrance of the earth and I am the heat in fire. I am the life of all that lives, all that lives. And I am the
penances
of all ascetics. Yes.
So, Praneet, you've smelled the earth after the first rain. When it rains for the first time, that there is some nice smell, no, coming?
Yeah. From
the earth. Yes, that smell is Krishna. Krishna says, I am that smell. Okay. So, the earth, that smell is Krishna. And he also is the heat in the fire. See, you can see here in Antarctica or something, they have igloos and all, no? Where they stay, they light the fire and they sit. You get warmth in that. That heat is Krishna. That's why when you cook, that consciousness in which you cook, that also affects you. If you cook happily that day, the food will be very tasty. If you cook very sad and angry mood, the taste will be bad because your consciousness, your thoughts are carried through the fire because that heat in the fire is Krishna and Krishna is in your heart as Paramatma, right? So you should be always happy while cooking. You should sing a Krishna song or something and then be happy while cooking because you're doing it for Krishna. And he's the life of all that lives. You can see a plant here, a person here, anything, some worms in the mud, anything that lives is Krishna is the life. Okay. And all the penances of ascetics, because some people, they do penances. Penances means austerity or tapasya, what you do. That and all is Krishna again. So Krishna is showing us what all Krishna is. How can we start seeing Krishna? See, now we'll see who is what and what amount. Among the taste, Krishna is the taste of water. Light, he is the moon and the sun. Om, the signal Om, the symbol Om in Vedic mantra is Krishna. The sound of ether is Krishna. The smell, fragrance means the smell of earth is Krishna. And the heat in the fire is Krishna. So when you start seeing that, Krishna is all around us, right? At the same time, Krishna is in our heart as Paramatma. At the same time, Krishna is in Golok Vrindavan doing his pastimes eternally. At the same time, he is there everywhere. How is that possible? That is the Achintya Shakti, inconceivable Shakti of Krishna. We can't be like that. See, Aishwarya can be at home now. I can't be in my hospital. I can't be anywhere else. Okay, because I'm a Jivatma. I'm just a soul, living entity. I can't be like Krishna. But Krishna is unlimited. You can't be able to understand him. He's so vast. He can be in your heart, not only my heart, all living entities' heart, he's there. At the same time, he is the moon, the sun, he's the taste of water. He's there everywhere. That is the Achintya Shakti of Krishna. We are not able to understand that. Okay. So what Krishna says, how can we go back to Krishna? Ananya, can you read? If possible, you read the sloka or translation, whatever you like. Able to read the sloka? Good. Ananya? Yes. Let's try.
Daivi he esa gunamai. Mataji, I am unable to read the sloka. So I'll
yeah, translation, read. Translation. Yes, read the translation. What happened? I can't hear you. Ananya? You are unmuted. Something happened. Kaushik, can you read? Yes, Kaushik. Fast, we don't have
Dai, time. Daivi he esa gunamai mama maya durataya mam eva eva e parpa dante mayam ettam taranti te.
Yes, translation.
This divine energy of mind consisting of the three modes of material nature is difficult to overcome, but those who have surrendered unto me can easily cross beyond it.
Very good. Yes. So this sloka says, Devishesha gunamai mama maya durataya mame vaya prapatyante maya me tam tarantite. So maya is the material energy. Okay. And there are three modes of material nature. I will teach you later. Just understand there are three modes of material nature. Goodness, passion, ignorance. Okay. If you want to cross this, when you should surrender to Krishna, then you can easily cross it. Okay. I'll give you an example. Vaishnavi, Hare Krishna Vaishnavi.
Hare imagine Krishna,
you are in a, Hare Krishna, you are in a traffic jam. Okay. So you're sitting inside the car, you have to go to school, and you're in a traffic jam, okay? And half an hour you're inside the traffic jam, okay? So you're not able to go, no? You can't move. Yes, but imagine if a helicopter comes or some machine, it comes and picks your car and go. Then can you reach school?
Yes, Mataji.
Similarly, if you want to cross a big ocean, okay, can you swim and cross alone?
No, Mataji.
Even if you are a big Olympiad in swimming, still you need a big boat to cross the ocean, right?
Yes, Mataji.
Yes, thank you. Similarly, we are all in this material world, Dukkhalaya. We are like this person. See, we are like full of problems here. And we can't swim across this ocean alone. We can't do it. We are like in a traffic jam. So if somebody comes like Krishna, okay, on top of Garuda, if he comes and just lift you from here and go, then we can just be happy. Like as if a helicopter comes and takes your car and go, as if a big boat will come and take you across the ocean. So similarly, this is Krishna's mercy. So if you want to cross this world, these problems, then you have to surrender to Krishna. And then you can easily cross it, Krishna. Cross this world. Okay. So it is said like if you have so big ocean to cross, but instead it will become like a small pond where you can just cross if you have Krishna's mercy. And how can we start surrendering to Krishna? Charu, how can we start the process of surrendering to Krishna by? How can we do it? You know? Jayashree?
No, Mataji.
What did we do in the beginning of the class? Beginning of the class, what did we all do? Navya, what is the process in Kali Yuga which will take us across?
By chanting Hare Krishna.
Very good.
We can surrender to Krishna.
Very good. Yes, that by chanting Hare Krishna. Harirnama, Harirnama, Iva Kevalam Kalo, Nasteva, Nasteva, Nasteva Gadiranyada. Yes. So that is the process of crossing across this material world. Okay. So how can we cross? By chanting this holy name. Yes, Niranjan, what is that? Harirnama?
Harirnama, 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 Iva Kevalam Kalo, Nasteva, Nasteva, Nasteva Gadiranyada.
Is the meaning, Niranjan?
Mataji, there is no other way, and there is no other way to reach or surrender to Krishna instead of chanting the holy name. Hare Krishna.
Yeah, only chanting the holy name can take you across. No other way in the Kali Yuga. Don't forget that in the Kali Yuga. We are living in Kali Yuga, so we should follow that. Okay? So that's how we can reach Krishna. And then one more sloka Krishna says, who are the people who surrender to Krishna? Sai Ganesh, can you read? What are the people who surrender to Krishna?
Mataji.
Yes, Hare Krishna.
Chaturvidha bhajante mam janaha sukritino juna arto jidnasur artarti jnanicha bharatar sabha.
Yes, translation.
O best among the Bharatas, Arjuna, four kinds of payas, men render devotional service unto me. The distressed, the desire of wealth, the inquisitive, and he who is searching for knowledge of the absolute.
Yes. So, four people will surrender to Krishna. Chaturvita pachante mam, jnana sukridino Arjuna, arto jitnyasura artarti, jnana cha bharatarshapa. Four people, arto, artarto, jnani, jitnyasu. Okay, see, you can see some people are very much distressed. Okay, so they are in problem. Some people are so much in problem. Some people, they want money. See this man, he wants money. Okay, and some people, they want to know. Inquisitive means they want to know about God. Who's God? Who's God? And somebody is searching for knowledge. So four people surrender to Krishna. Who are they? Artho, Artartho, Jnani, Jitnyasu. One is in distress. See, some people are very sad. They have some problem in life. They go to temple. Oh, let me go to temple and pray to Krishna. Okay, please Krishna help me. That is the time they start surrendering to Krishna when they have problem, distress. Desire of wealth. If somebody is poor, they want money. That people also go to God. Krishna, give me my daily bread. Give me money. I want money. So that is second class. Third is inquisitive. Some scientists and all, some people that they want to know what is God, who is God. So such people. And some people are searching the truth or knowledge. Okay. They want to know what is the goal of life. So four people will surrender to Krishna. Now I'll show you the examples of people who have surrendered to Krishna. Okay, so this is Gajendra. You know Gajendra? Gajendra was an elephant. He was Indradyumna Maharaj in his previous life. Gajendra, once he went, this elephant was taking bath in a pond and one crocodile caught his leg and he could not fight against it. He could not escape. And finally, he cried for God and Vishnu came on the top of Garuda and saved him. So Gajendra is in distress, right? He is in problem. That is one. Then who is this? Draupadi. Remember? She was, all the Pandavas, they lost, right? And she was dragged in the Sabha, no? And she was, her sari was pulled. That who helped? Krishna. She raised both the hands and called, Krishna, Govinda, help me. And Krishna gave the sari. So even she was in distress. So four types of people surrender to Krishna. One is in distress, that is problem. One who want money, then one who wants to know about the truth, one who wants to know knowledge, okay, the absolute truth. So these two were in distress. And even here, you can see this is Vyasadeva and Vyasadeva's wife, Vatika. She was pregnant with Shukadev Goswami. And Shukadev Goswami stayed in a womb for 16 years. He didn't come out. And then finally, Krishna had to come and call Shukadev Goswami out. Okay, that is a big story. I will tell you later. That's in Bhagavatam. When you come for Bhakti Vriksha, I will tell you. So Krishna came and helped Vatika. She was also in distress. So these three people, Gajendra, Draupadi, and Shukadev Goswami's Vyasadeva's wife, all three were in problem, distress. So they surrendered to Krishna. Then here, Shukadev Goswami is explaining to Parikshit Maharaj. Okay, that is the place where Shukadev Goswami was explaining to Parikshit Maharaj about Bhagavatam. So Parikshit was cursed to be bitten by a snake in 7 days. So he's inquisitive. He want to know more about what should I do in the 7 days? What can I learn? And then he started hearing from Shukadev Goswami about Bhagavatam. That is inquisitive. And this is Dhruva Maharaj. Dhruva Maharaj wanted wealth. He wanted to become a big king like his father. So he was wanted wealth. He went to Krishna. Then finally he got Krishna. And remember, when Ram and Sugriva and they all were in they became friends. No, why? Because Sugriva's wife was kidnapped. So he wanted his kingdom and wife back. For that he surrendered. And this is Naimisharanya. The sages were asking questions. This is also in Bhagavatam. They want to know the truth. So you can see here all four kinds of people who are in distress, who want money, who's inquisitive, and who want to know the truth. These are the four people who surrender to Krishna. Now I'll tell you the story of Dhruva Maharaj. Just understand, this is in Bhagavatam in details, but just I'll tell you a short story. Dhruva Maharaj, Dhruva Maharaj's father Uttanapada had two wives. First wife was Suniti, and whose son was Dhruva Maharaj, and second wife was Surichi. She had another son called Uttama. So this Dhruva Maharaj's mother was very silent, innocent. So she never complains anything. But the second wife was not like that. And the second wife's child was sitting on the lap of his father. So they were just 5 years old. Dhruva Maharaj was just 5 years old. He also wanted to sit on the father's lap. It's usual, no? Kids will want to sit on the father's lap. So when Dhruva Maharaj one day saw his father, he told, "Let me sit on your lap." And when he was sitting, Suruchi, the stepmother, came and told, "You get out, you get down, you can't sit on your father's lap because you are not eligible to become the king and you are not born from my womb." Then what happened? Dhruva Maharaj was feeling very bad for what happened. And when he felt bad, he went to his mother first and he told, "What should I do? I am not able to become a king. So what should I do?" So his mother told, "You go and meditate on the Lord. Only Lord can help you." Then finally, he met Narad Muni. So Dhruva Maharaj, he left home, and when he was going, he met Narad Muni. Narad Muni is the great devotee of Lord, and Narad Muni blessed him. If you get the blessing of a devotee, then you get Krishna very easily. So Narad Muni blessed him. And where did Dhruva Maharaj go? He went to the forest. He was just 5 years old. He went to the forest and he did severe tapasya for 6 months. He was eating just fruits, vegetables, whatever is available. Then he started eating the fruits and the flowers and the leaves. Then he drank some water. Then he did tapasya. See, in one leg he was standing and he was doing tapasya of the Lord. He was just 5 years old. And everybody was so shocked how he is. Finally, the God appeared in front of him after 6 months. And then the Lord blessed Dhruva Maharaj with his conch shell. He blessed him. Dhruva Maharaj, why did he do all this? To become the king. He wanted money. But then when he saw the Lord, he forgot to ask for everything. He don't want any money anymore. He just want his blessings. But finally, he became the king. Dhruva Maharaj. So this is how, if you approach God and if you sincerely pray, you will surely get God. This is the sloka you need to remember. So this is the sloka you need to remember for tomorrow. Memorize this sloka. So what is this sloka says? Bahunam janma namante jnanavan mam prabhatyate vasudeva sarvam iti samahatma sudhurlabha. So let me chant the sloka, then you repeat after me. You can unmute. Bahunam janma namante.
Bahunam janma namante.
Jnanavan mam prabhatyate.
Jnanavan mam prabhatyate.
Vasudeva sarvam iti.
Vasudeva sarvam iti.
Mahatma sudhurlabha.
Mahatma sudhurlabha.
This is an important sloka. That's why I told to memorize this sloka. Bahunam janmanam ante. Bahunam. So we have taken 84 lakh life, right? So bahunam means many. Janmana, janma means birth. Ante, ante means end. So after the end of many janma, what will happen? Jnanavan mam prabhatyate. Only the person who is in knowledge will surrender to Krishna. And what will he understand? Vasudeva Sarvamidi. Everything is Krishna's. Sa Mahatma Sudurlabha. Such pure souls. Mahatmas are rare. What is the translation? Manish, can you read the translation?
Yes, ma'am. Mataji, can you hear me?
Yes, yes.
After many births and deaths, he who is actually in knowledge surrenders unto me.
Mm.
Knowing me to be the cause of all causes and all that is.
Mm.
Such a great soul is very rare.
Yes. So after many births and deaths, I told you, birth, death, old age, disease. My soul have got this human body now. But my soul was a fish in my previous life. I was a crocodile. I was a tortoise. I was a bird. I was a plant. I was an animal. I was a monkey. So I was my soul. My soul have entered so many bodies, right? And I had took birth so many times. I have died many times, right? But the soul doesn't have death. The body dies. So the soul have left. So when my one body dies, the soul leaves the body and goes to another body. When that body dies, I go to another body. Like that, I had so many births and deaths. But after all these births and deaths, if some person is in good knowledge, they surrender to Krishna. Knowing Krishna to be the cause of all cause. Sarva karana karanam. Krishna is the cause of all cause. And such great souls are very rare. There are only few people who can actually surrender to Krishna. So this is the sloka you should memorize for tomorrow. 7th chapter, 19th sloka. Please note it down. Take a screenshot. Bahuna, I'll tell you, I'll anyway send the notes. Bahunam janmanam ante jnanavan mam prabhatyate vasudeva sarvam iti samahatma sudurlabha. Okay, who can chant the sloka? Anyone know the sloka?
Yes, Mataji, I can chant.
Yes.
Bahunam janma namante jnanam jnanavamam praptaye vasudevaya sarvamiti cha mahatma sudurlabha.
Very good. Yes. So this is the sloka and you should all learn the sloka. What does that mean? It means that after many births, that one person can surrender to Krishna and know Krishna as the cause of all cause. Okay. Bahunam janmanam ante jnanavan mam prabhatyate vasudeva sarvam iti sa mahatma sudurlabha. When you want to memorize the sloka, you write it down first. Okay. You write it in a notebook. Then you read each and every word. You understand the meaning. And then you try to by heart the sloka. Don't just mug up. Understand the meaning and try to learn the sloka. Because the slokas is spoken by Krishna. So this is Krishna himself. There is no difference between Bhagavad Gita and Krishna. It is Krishna himself. So he becomes happy when you chant the slokas of Krishna. Okay. So I will chant. You chant at home. I'm not unmuting. Just chant with me. Bahunam janmanam ante jnanavan mam prapatyate vasudeva sarvam iti samahatma sudurlabha. Okay, that's the sloka you should learn. Then Krishna also says something else. Navya, can you read? What does Krishna say?
Hare Krishna Mataji, I can. Oh, yes. Arjuna, as the Supreme Personality of Godhead, I know everything that has happened in the past, all that is happening in the present, and all things that are yet to come. I also know all living entities, but me, no one knows.
Yes. So Krishna knows the past, present and future. Okay. Navya, are you there? Are you unmuted? Navya, you've gone to a movie theater, film theater?
Yes, Mataji.
Okay. Yes. So if you go, once the movie have started, okay, the movie already started. And you went after the interval. Something happened. You were in traffic jam. You went after the interval. So can you understand what is happening in the movie?
No, ma'am.
Yeah, you can see the villain chasing the heroine. Villain kidnapping the heroine. The hero coming. But you really can't relate, no? What is happening?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Similarly, we are all like that. We are like in the middle of a show, okay? We are all born in this earth and we don't know where we are. But Krishna is like the director of the movie. Krishna knows everything. Krishna knows your previous janma. Krishna knows your present janma. Krishna also knows your future janma, what's going to happen. Even in this janma, I don't know tomorrow what's going to happen. Tomorrow anything can happen. I don't know. Only Krishna knows. We are like how we entered into a movie theater, no? Once the movie have started and we just go and we don't know what is happening. Everybody is running. Some people are fighting. We can't relate anything. Similarly, whatever is happening in our life, we can't understand. Why is this corona? Why are we locked down? Why don't we have school now? What is this happening? But Krishna knows everything. He knows what happened in the past. He knows what is happening in the present. He also knows what is yet to come in the future. He knows everything. He's like the director of the movie. The movie, no? The director, he knows everything. He knows how the movie started, how it's going to end. But we don't know. We are like in the middle of the movie. We don't know what is happening. But we can trust Krishna and move when alone, along, because Krishna will always do good for us. Okay? This corona problem also will end one day. This is all a karma coming back. Many people have killed many animals and it's all coming back. The karmas, we can't do anything. So at least now onwards, we should live a good life. We should not hurt animals and we should not get that karma back. So Krishna, he tells, oh Arjuna, as the Supreme Personality of Godhead, I know everything. Krishna is himself saying, I know everything that happened in the past, which is good, happening in the present, and that's yet to come. Sometimes we feel, no, why this happened to me? Why does this happen? Krishna knows. In future, in after so many years, we'll think, oh, that day this happened because of this. We can connect things. We can relate things. See, because of corona, all of you people, there are 95 students here, all have come to learn Bhagavad Gita. You all started chanting, right? If no corona, you will be busy with your school studies. You won't be able to understand Gita or you won't be able to chant. So this is all for a good reason. Everything happens for good. And Krishna knows everything. Krishna knows all living entity. See, I know about my body. Okay. I know what is good for my body. What food is allergic to me. Which medicines is allergic to me. I know. But only about my body. I don't know about other bodies. But Krishna knows about all, everyone. But Krishna, no one knows. We can't understand Krishna because he's so unlimited. But yes, we can understand Krishna. How can we understand Krishna? How can we understand Krishna? Samanvita? Can you guess? How can we understand Krishna? Samanvita? Just try, Nagendra. How can we start understanding Krishna? Mm-hmm. Avish? If they don't know the answer, they are not unmuting. Riya? That's okay.
Yes, Mataji. Mataji, by chanting and
very good. Yeah, by chanting Hare Krishna, by reading Bhagavad Gita, we can understand Krishna, right? Very good. Yes. So, and Krishna's mercy also should be there. Krishna also should think, oh, Riya is trying to know me. Riya is studying Bhagavad Gita. Let me reveal myself to her and Krishna will reveal to you. That's how you'll know about Krishna. Okay, otherwise we can't know about Krishna. Okay, now all these days you are asking questions to us. No, Mataji, what is that question? Mataji, I have a question. Mataji raising hand and putting in the chat. Now let me ask you people the question. Okay, so we'll have a question answer session. And my co-host, please unmute people, whoever raising their hand, please unmute one person, okay? Yeah, we are.
Yeah, let's start with Pujashree.
Yeah, Pujashree. Very simple question, simple questions it is. If you don't know, we will discuss, okay? No problem. It's not a quiz or anything. Yes.
Okay, Mataji.
Yes, this is for you, Pujashree. Who is God? Is God a person?
He is person.
Yeah, who is God? What is his name?
Krishna.
Yes. So who is God? Krishna is God and he is a person. Very good. The second question, who are we? Next person, Mataji? Not you, Pujashree. Next person.
Yeah, I'll unmute you.
Leave. Students, please don't leave. This is good. Some questions will come from this for your final quiz. So be alert and just try to learn.
Kaundinya Sai.
Mataji, we are spiritual souls. We are not
very evil. Very good. What is your age?
9 years.
Who are we? We are spirit souls. We are not this body. Very good. Excellent. Yes, the next question, Mataji.
Yeah. Next person is Priyam.
What are the three reasons why Krishna appeared? What are the reasons why Krishna appeared? Three reasons?
To restore dharma, to kill demons, and to help his devotees.
Very good. Excellent. Yes. Oh, all are so good. Okay. The next question, Mataji. What is Bhagavad Gita? What is Gita? We are learning. What is it actually?
Fourth person is Bharka Nair.
Bharka, what is Bhagavad Gita? Whatever you know, you tell. What is Bhagavad Gita actually?
Bhagavad Gita which Krishna speaks.
It is spoken by Krishna. Gita means song. Bhagavad means Bhagavan. So it's a song of Krishna. It's like a love letter of Krishna, right? It is the song spoken by Krishna. How many verses are there in Bhagavad Gita? How many chapters? 700 verses. How many chapters? 18 chapters, 700 verses. Very good. Excellent. Yes, next person. Why do we study Bhagavad Gita? Why are we studying?
Niranjan.
Why are we studying?
Mataji, we study Bhagavad Gita to understand Krishna.
Yes, very good. Vedaishya Sarvam Ahameva Vedyam. So the main purpose to study Bhagavad Gita is to understand Krishna. It is a life manual, right? Yes, very good. Next person, Mataji.
Kriti Kosgi.
What are the five reasons what Arjuna told in the first chapter not to fight? What are the five reasons? Arjuna told, no, I can't fight Krishna because of this, 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 this. What are the five reasons? Anyone? One reason? He was thinking, how can I kill my teachers, my cousins, right? Why did he think like that? Next person, maybe she don't know. Next one.
Markham.
Yeah, Markham knows.
Yes, Mataji. Sin, compassion, indecision, family tradition, no enjoyment.
See, this is how students should be. You should say. Sin. So Arjuna thought that it will be sin to kill my elders. Then it was compassion. He was feeling daya for them. Then he thought family traditions will be lost if I kill my cousins. Then what else? Indecision. He was not able to decide, right? So these are all many reasons what Arjuna thought, I should not fight, right? Yes, good. Very good. Okay, Mataji, next.
Next, Kanav.
What is yoga? We discussed today. What is yoga? The meaning of yoga. Okay, next question. No problem, you can learn. Yoga means? Mataji, next person.
Vaishnavi, unmute.
Yoga means connecting to God, Mataji.
Very good. Yoga means connecting to God.
To God, yes, Mataji.
Yes. Okay, Kanav, understood, no? Yoga means connecting to God. Now, which are the four yugas? Which are the four yuga?
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, which are the four yugas?
Yeah.
Satya Yuga, Treta Yuga, Dwapara Yuga and Kali Yuga.
Very good. And which yuga are we living now?
Kali Yuga.
Very good. Yes. Now next person. So now we are in Kali Yuga. Sai Ganesh, what is dharma in Kali Yuga?
But we should chant Hare Krishna and holy names of the Lord.
Yes. Chanting the holy name of Krishna is the dharma in Kali Yuga. So let us all do that dharma. Please unmute and do that dharma. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare
Krishna. Okay. So that is the dharma in Kali Yuga, to chant the holy name of Krishna. Yes, Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. What is peace formula? You remember the same peace formula?
Yes, Mataji. The first one is Krishna is the supreme controller. Second is the supreme enjoyer. And third is the only well-wisher friend.
Very good. Excellent. Oh, Krishna, I have all genius in my class. Very good. So, peace formula is Krishna is the enjoyer. Yes, Charvi. Krishna is the enjoyer. Krishna is the controller. And Krishna is our only best well-wishing friend. This is the peace formula. Very good. What is the Hare Krishna Mahamantra? You all know that. I don't have to ask. It's Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Yes, what is Panchatattva mantra? Next person. Panchatattva.
Yes, Mataji. Jai Shri Krishna, Chaitanya, Prabhu Nityananda, Shri Advaita Gadadara, Shri Vasadi, Gaurav Bhakta Vrinda.
Yes, very good. Yes, that is the Panchatattva mantra. Very good. Why should we chant Hare Krishna? Why should we chant Hare Krishna?
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Hare Krishna. Why should we chant?
We should chant Hare Krishna to get rid of from this life and go with Krishna.
Very good. Yes. To go back to Krishna, we should chant. What does the word Krishna means? I think I didn't discuss this, but somebody can try. Krishna means what? I think we discussed.
Krishna is the God.
Yeah, but you know the word meaning of Krishna?
No, Mata.
That's okay. I think I didn't discuss this. Krishna means all attractive. He's attracting everyone. Okay? Krishna attracts everyone. Krishna attracts even the Cupid. You know the Cupid, the Kamadev? He went to Vrindavan one day. And he, Cupid is like
the Mataji.
Huh? Yes, Hare Krishna. So this Cupid is a person who is like very handsome. Okay. So he went to Vrindavan with his arrow and he wanted to shoot Krishna. So Krishna was not turning to him. Suddenly when Krishna turned, this Cupid saw Krishna and from the tree he fell down, the Cupid. So Krishna is called Madana Mohana because he can attract even the Cupid. Okay. Cupid attracts all of us. But Krishna gets attracted by the Cupid and so Krishna is called Madana Mohana. So the word Krishna means all attracts everyone. Okay, that is the meaning of Krishna. I think I'm done. Yeah. Yeah, okay. So chant Hare Krishna and be happy. And just don't go. Just